spells into your happy zone. 1. Stay connected. Relationships are the number one source of our well-being. Not just the ones our close friends, family and friends, but also our wider network too. Instead of thinking of covert restrictions as social distancing, think of it as physical distancing. Love is our supreme emotion, and eye contact is essential for that. So much, make the most of Zoom, or FaceTime, or keep in touch. 2. Spend time in nature. Take a few minutes of activity outdoors and start producing positive emotions. But it is that you don't have to think about it. You just have to be out there. Get physical. One of the best ways to lift your mood is by moving the body. Study comparing the effect of antidepressants and exercise on people with depression showed that the lowest rate of that relapse was the group who exercised. It might be a daily walk or dancing around the kitchen to music. Or on a mini trampoline, 10 minutes a day, with 80s tunes blowing out the radio. 4. Use music to influence your mood. If you're feeling sad, it's tempting to put on a melancholy song, but try something upbeat instead and notice how much better it makes you feel. 5. Make a happiness playlist. When you're feeling low, sometimes hard to think of things that you might help you. If you have a little, why don't you have a mood boosting activities where you turn into whatever you need, a pick me up. Do one of these things every day and you see the benefit. Learn to play. Deprived of many of our social activities and hobbies in lockdown, not to mention school. And soft play venues. We must learn to create our own fun, whether it is baking, gardening or doing jigsaws. Activity creation is better for well-being than passive leisure like watching TV. If you can make things flow, a state of engagement, you're really fully absorbed in an activity. Something that puts you in the zone, gives you a deeper feeling of satisfaction, and adds to your base level of contentment. 7. Hunt for the good stuff. Our brain is hardwired to notice what's wrong or what's missing, so we have trained it to find the positives. Start thinking about the good things you have, even when there's those tough times. It might be your health and family, or something as simple as your partner cooking your dinner. 8. Think Japanese. Have an inkuro, I-K-I-J-A-L, which is a reason for getting up in the morning. So you set yourself small goals, something you could do which is so within your control. You might be finishing reading the novel you had, or to go for a while, or clean the kitchen cupboards. This is perfectly good if you feel your life is on hold because of COVID restrictions. Taking a small step of goal gives you a sense of that achievement. Just be careful not to have too many goals or something that might not achieve them. It's about making progress, not perfection. 9. Find mindfulness. This is a practice of being rather than doing, turning our awareness into the inner and outer landscape, but turning into the body and our environment. Tuning into our body and environment. There are plenty of apps available, and just a short mindful session can help ease anxiety. Similarly, try savoring positive moments as they happen. See the positive moments as they happen. As you are here now, you could be savoring the pleasure you get from watching your children play or enjoying a good meal. 10. Practice kindness. When you do a good deed for others, you feel good. They feel good. You contributed to the greater good too. We saw lockdown how volunteers supported essential work services and each other. Volunteering has many benefits for well-being. 11. Take time for care. Our 21st century living seems to want the white bulb world reset. But you can't pour from an empty cup. In times of stress, it's important to get into a relaxation zone. Many of us keep going and going till we burn out. So whatever works for you, whether that's a bath, meditation, or having a cuppa. Number 12. The final one. Be kind to your body. Avoid too much alcohol, caffeine and sugar. Eat healthy, have plenty of fruit and vegetables. Drink lots of water. Carbs are comforting when we're feeling stressed. A single square of dark chocolate is said to be good for boosting the mood. And as is green tea, which can lower levels of stress, hormone, queries low, and reduce the risk of depression. Bounce! Into a happy zone.